somebody saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam going into Sadda, so he ran to Abu Jahl and he said to Abu Jahl, Oh Abu Jahl, you had made this promise, go Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's in prostration. Abu Jahl, when he came, he went forward and all of a sudden he just leapt back again. So when he leapt back, he didn't do anything. He was going to go to hit the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the people, they came to him and they said to him that, Oh Abu al-Hakam, why have you all of a sudden gone back? Why didn't you do anything? What happened? So he said to him that, didn't you see what I saw? So they said to him that, no, we didn't see anything. He said to him that all of a sudden, all the zameen, all the earth and all the sky, it just closed up upon me. Everything just went dark. And now there's another narration, and in the other narration he says that I saw between me and I saw between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a huge trench full of blazing fire. So he says, when I saw this, he said, I moved back. So obviously, if you put the two narrations together, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he took away his eyesight. He couldn't see anything. The only thing that he could see was a huge trench between him and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, full of blazing fire. Now you think that after witnessing something like this, Abu Jahl, if he had some sense, he wouldn't attempt again to go and hit or attack or say anything to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But enmity, it was embedded in his heart so much that many times after this, again and again, he tried to hurt the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One day again, he was in the Haram of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala near the Kaaba, and he addressing the people, he said to them that, oh people, as you can see, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is going around refuting the idols that you prostrate, and he is mocking your forefathers, and he is making them to look as they were astray and deviated from the straight path. I make a promise in front of you people that tomorrow morning I am going to go and I am going to get such a storm. I am going to get such a storm, something that he will never ever be able to survive. Once he goes into prostration, I am going to smash this rock down on his head, which will totally finish him. If you people want to help me, you can give me refuge from his family. If not, then may the enemy take me. May the enemy take me, let them do what they want, but at least everybody will be at peace from this calamity that has befallen us. Now, as he had made this promise, in the morning, he goes and he is waiting near the Kaaba for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is hiding there. In the morning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to his blessed habit, he came to place salah. And he went near the Kaaba, and as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was praying salah, everybody was in their houses waiting for the news to come that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been killed by Abu Jahl. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he goes into sajda, Abu Jahl comes and he's got this huge rock in his hand, and just as he's about to smash it, his whole body begins trembling and he just leaps back once again. He goes back once again. The people that came out of the houses, they seen the Abu Jahl, his face has changed, his whole body is trembling, he's swaying, he's cold. They ask him, oh Abu al-Hakam, what happened? What happened this time? He says, didn't you see what I saw? They said to him, no. He says that I saw a huge, powerful, very, very strong camel running towards me, something that I have never ever seen in my life before. He says it was about to eat me. And in another narration, again it says that I have seen between me and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam a trench, the same size as what he had seen before, huge, full of blazing fire again. When this incident was mentioned in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah Akbar, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that was Jibreel. That was Jibreel, and if he was to come anywhere near me, Jibreel would have taken him out, Jibreel would have grabbed him. Now it could mean that Jibreel had come in the form of a camel which was charging towards Abu Jahl, or it could mean that Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he was on top of the camel, riding the camel, charging towards Abu Jahl. It could mean any one of the two, because if you look in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said that was Jibreel, as in what, the camel was Jibreel, or was Jibreel on the camel? So it could mean one of the two. Now it's been narrated from Munib Ghamdi that he says it wasn't, as in what this narration is going to be showing us is, it wasn't only Abu Jahl, it wasn't only Abu Lahab, it wasn't only the leaders of Quraysh that would cause grief and trouble to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even the general public, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would walk about in the streets of Makkah al-Mukarramah. Even the children, the women, the youngsters, the old, the ill, they would all cause a some sort of grief and trouble to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Munib Ghandi, he says that one day I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and again he was saying, "Qulu la ilaha illallah tuflihu." That oh people, say la ilaha illallah, and you'll be saved. You'll be successful. You'll be saved on the fire of Jahannam. He says when he was going around saying this, he says that some unfortunate, zalim, badbakht people, what they were doing is they were spitting on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he ignored it. Some people, he was saying, they were swearing at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and some people had trash and they had mud in their hands and they were throwing it on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But he ignored every single one of them. He didn't say anything. He says until it was midday. We can just see how long the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was walking about in the marketplaces, in the streets, calling the people until midday. Until midday, he's calling people. He says that after this, I seen a young girl coming, and she began washing the hands, the blessed hands of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the blessed face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, I asked the people that who is this young girl. They said that this is the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hazrat Zainab. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to Hazrat Zainab radiyallahu ta'ala anha, that don't fear your father being disgraced or your father being upset. Obviously, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They must have felt something in their heart, but it just shows how firm and how steadfast they were also on their iman. That after seeing their father being beaten, after seeing their father being sworn, after seeing their father being abused by even the general public, let alone the leaders, even then they wouldn't prevent their father from going out and spreading the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Urwa ibn Zubair radiallahu ta'ala, he says that one day I asked Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he says that I asked him that, oh Abdullah, tell me some of the troubles that the polytheists, the mushrikeen of Makkah, they caused to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, he says, now I'll tell you about one day, he says, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Hatim near the Kaaba. He says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reading Salah when Uqba ibn Abi Mu'id, he was also one of those leaders that had caused a lot of trouble to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says that I saw Uqba ibn Abi Mu'id coming and he had a cloth in his hand, and with this cloth he put it around the neck of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he pulled the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so hard that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam began choking. There was nobody there. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he was passing by and he seen what was going on. He ran and he punched Uqba ibn Abi Mu'id. He pushed him to the extent that he went back, leaving go of the cloth. And after this, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he stood there and he said, أَتَقْتُلُونَ رَجُلًا أَنْ يَقُولَ رَبِّيَ اللَّهُ وَقَدَ جَاءَكُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. This is the Quran. He read it. He said that, are you trying to kill a person who is saying that my Lord is Allah, even though clear proofs have come to you from your Lord? So Uqba ibn Abi Mu'ayy, he went away. Muhammad ibn Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he says that one day I saw Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala standing on the minbar, giving a wa'az, giving nasihat, a khutbah to the people. And during this khutbah, he said that, O people, who is the most bravest person that you have seen? So all the people, with one voice, they all said that, O Ali, it is you. You are the bravest person that we have seen. So Hazrat Ali, he said that, verily, whoever has come to fight me, I have taken my revenge. But he says, the bravest person, you know, this is something to listen to. Because, you know, for those people that look Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, those people who think Hazrat Ali to be a god, this is what Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu has to say about the one and only Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Look what he has to say, and look how much love he has for Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq. He says that, O people, the bravest person that I have seen is Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And when he says this, he begins crying. On the minbar of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's standing there. You can just imagine it. Thousands of sahaba in front of him, hundreds of tabi'een in front of him. Hazrat Ali, he's a crime, and he said to these people, he said that the bravest person that I have seen is Abu Bakr Siddiq. Why? He says that one day we were all standing there when the mushrikeen of Makkah, they began beating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said the only person to pluck up some courage and go forward and save the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Hazrat Abu Bakr. He charged in to the gathering and the bunch where they were beating the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the way Hazrat Ali describes it, he says he was given one punch here and he was given one punch there, and this is how he prevented the mushrikeen of Makkah being the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then after this, he began crying again and again. He's crying and he's saying, then he talks about the man from the family of Fir'aun. Now this ayah that I mentioned, أَتَقْتُلُونَ رَجُلًا أَنْ يَقُولَ رَبِّيَ اللَّهُ. This ayah, the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended this ayah was at the time of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when Musa and Haman, when they were plotting to kill Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, a man from the family of Fir'aun, he went and he warned Musa alayhi salatu wasalam because he had become a Muslim. He had brought Iman upon Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, but he hadn't told Fir'aun, or he told Haman, he was hiding his Iman. So he went and he told Musa alayhi salatu wasalam that it is best if you go away from here because these people are plotting to kill you. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam went away. So this person, they call him the person from the family of Fir'aun. So when Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he's addressing these people, he says, oh people, who is better, the person from the family of Fir'aun or Abu Bakr? So everybody, all these Sahaba and Tabi'een, they all silent, totally silent, waiting for the answer to come from Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, from Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. He says, he cries again and he says, the old people, I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one moment of Abu Bakr's life is far more greater and far more virtuous than the whole life of the man from the family of Fir'aun. Allahu Akbar, you know, we can see the reason why he was so high in the eyes of Hazrat Ali and in the eyes of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was because of his sacrifice for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in times of difficulty, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going through immense difficulty from his tribe, from his own family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to build love in our hearts for Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala an, and all the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, including the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inshallah, we'll be stopping there. Next week we'll be talking about how the mushrikeen deployed to stop the Muslims going around and spreading Islam and some of the plans that they had made. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.